The 40 Hadith of Imam Nawawi. Commentary by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Yaqubi.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Hadith 30. عن أبي ثعلبة الخشني جرثوم بن ناشر رضي الله تعالى عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. The narrator of this hadith is a Sahabi called Jurthum ibn Nashir. He attended Bay'at al-Ridwan at al-Hudaybiyah. He lived later on in Syria in a small town close to Damascus known as Dariya, and he died year 75 of al-Hijrah. He says, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فَرَضَ فَرَائِضَ فَلَا تُضَيِّعُوهَا. Allah prescribed on you several obligations, so do not miss them. وَحَدَّ حُدُودًا فَلَا تَعْتَدُوهَا. Allah set boundaries for you, so do not transgress these boundaries. وَحَرَّمَ أَشْيَاءَ فَلَا تَنْتَهِكُوهَا. And made things forbidden, so do not violate them. وَسَكَتَ عَنْ أَشْيَاءَ رَحْمَةً لَكُمْ غَيْرَ نِسْيَانٍ فَلَا تَبْحَثُوا عَنْهَا. Allah did not mention many things out of mercy to you, so do not search for them. This hadith is a good hadith, Hassan, narrated by Ad-Darqutni in his Sunan. Now we go back to this hadith and see how this hadith defines the injunctions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. First, there are obligations. So we need to abide by the obligation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made wajib on us. Obligatory upon us. فَلَا تُضَيِّعُوهَا. Do not miss them, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. وَحَدَّ حُدُودًا. There are boundaries between halal and haram, as we had it before. Halal is clear and haram is clear. They are sanctuaries. So do not transgress. وَحَرَّمَ أَشْيَاءَ فَلَا تَنْتَهِكُوهَا. Allah made things clearly forbidden, so do not violate the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah prohibits. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left things unspecified without telling us whether they are halal or haram, out of mercy. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is warning his companions here not to ask unwarranted questions that would make life difficult for them. Because leave it. If it is not specified as haram, just leave it. And this is one of the indications to the main rules that al-aslu fil ashya' al-ibaha, the original legal state of all matters is that they are halal, except things specified. This is one of the foundations of this rule in our Islamic law. It's a beautiful rule. الأصل في الأشياء الإباحة. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in the beginning was lawful. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified to us the harmful things that are made haram. So the haram is an exception from the halal. Hadith 31. عن سهل بن سعد الساعدي رضي الله عنه قال جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله دلني على عمل إذا عملته أحبني الله وأحبني الناس. قال ازهد في الدنيا يحبك الله وازهد فيما عند الناس يحبك الناس. حديث حسن رواه ابن ماجه. In this beautiful hadith, Sahal ibn Sa'd radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, one of al-Ansar, narrates That a man arrived to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asking for something. If he does, Allah loves him and people love him. So, two good things. He wanted Allah to love him and he wanted people to love him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave him this beautiful advice. Izhad fi dunya. This dunya Allah created for us just to manage our life. Don't get attached to it. Allah will love you if you turn to him and give away what you have and don't get your heart attached to a dunya. Real zuhd is in the heart, not in the hand. Get attached to Allah, not to the dunya. A lot of people misunderstand zuhd. They think that to be zahid is to give away everything and not to have anything of the dunya. That's a wrong understanding of the true nature of zuhd. The true nature of zuhd is attachment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to the dunya. The second part of this hadith, you want people to love you? Leave the dunya for them because they love it. Give them wealth, they will love you. Don't take from their wealth, they will love you. Two basic things. Dunya is actually the core of the two points. Get it out of your heart and have only your heart filled with iman, filled with love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will love you. And give people the dunya and they will love you. Don't have desire for it and then people will love you. Two basic things that roll about the dunya, but our hearts are with Allah. The key point in this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the dunya. Get it out of your heart, Allah will love you. Give it to people. Don't cling to it. People will love you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.